Erste Kinopremiere, was sagst du?
Ich bin so nervös, jetzt bin ich wirklich
echt.
Nervös. Das ist wirklich das Kino und da sitzen 100 Leute herin.
I've been working in the film industry for 7 years now. And it's been 12 years since I started pursuing this vision of having my life immersed in a creative world. This exchange I began to adore over the years, of putting energy into working on a project, which in exchange creates something else. A spark, an introspection, an emotion. And as it turns out, there's no official path for this. There's no clear way in how you can make a creative career. Sure, there are some trails that suggest a certain route that can help you out in some moments along the way. Schools and trainings and internships that will provide you with many things that you're gonna need. But none of them are obligatory or urgently necessary. In this world, there's a different value system present that detaches itself from anything else.
This might just be an opinion, but I hold it strongly. I kind of want to hold it strongly.
What are the essences that kept me moving forward throughout the last 7 years?
Because it can get super rough trying to navigate a huge industry without proper direction. This is definitely not a how-to guide. I'm not sure if a thing like that is out there. There are some traps I had to be mindful of, and there turned out to be one centerpiece that held everything together. All I can share here today is the things that I know. And I'm telling this story as I am on an adventure myself.
You know what that is?
That's a literal piece of volcano. I'm in Iceland, making a documentary about two cyclists who are on a mission to traverse the country. The highlands are known for its extremely rough climate. This project had turned out to be a huge turning point in my life. I didn't know that at that time. We'll get there, but as we started planning this out, a wall of challenges were ahead. We as a team often did not know whether or not we could succeed at doing this.
Yes! Nice!
Roadblocks are tough, especially in an environment where the odds seem against you, how I felt like when I started working in the industry. So this story proved me that there is a way to get to the other side, to overcome these traps.
So I hung out with a good friend a couple of days ago. He is doing something completely different than I do. And he basically expressed his frustration about how his work has consumed his life in a very negative way throughout the last years. These traps are everywhere in all working environments. And I believe that their character is that they express themselves in a way that feels like a trap to you. They're completely inevitable. So here are my big three traps that I came across.
It's been our last day in Reykjavik today. Just wanted to get out tonight to see how bright it is. Tomorrow we start our big expedition, our adventure.
Pursuing a creative career can very often sound much more appealing on paper than it is in reality. And to give in to the looseness of the industry happened a lot to me when I first started out. This gets extra harsh when you don't have stability yet. When you haven't yet found your set of clients, your niche you work in, or your network, your people. Something somewhat reliable to count on. And having this as a starting situation can seem extremely daunting and overwhelming. I broke twice and went to university to study something completely random. First time was in 2015 when I began a degree in mathematics and biology to become a teacher. During that time I waited to be accepted to an internship as a video editor at the Red Bull Media House. And I had no clue if and when I would actually be able to start working there. In the end, I think after 4 months I got accepted. I was able to work there.
And I definitely didn't see that at the time, but that internship would turn into the biggest stepping stones I've gotten in my life. One opportunity that turned into hundreds throughout the years.
Second time giving in was 2 years later. And even though in retrospect, things were definitely moving into an interesting direction back then, I didn't see it at all. I doubted everything. So back to university, English and geography. That had probably lasted for 2 months this time, until at one day I've gotten so frustrated by this whole environment there. I decided to switch horses again, and this time to fully focus on a creative career. I was getting really frustrated by the outlooks of my life. When this happened, I definitely knew that I had to go for it now. And nothing apart from shooting and making videos would slightly excite me. It's crazy now that it had to take a total of 6 months. That goes to show you how much I craved stability and what I was ready to sacrifice for it.
Put up the tent right now. It's super windy.
tomorrow in the morning we're gonna start our expedition. I'm super excited.
It's really hard to surrender to that looseness and trust that your skill set and your work, what you've been doing, will kind of guide you through it. Next trap is kind of the opposite of what I just said before. Basically, there is not a better time in history to become a video editor or anything on this spectrum than right now. Really. Every single company expands to the virtual realms right now. And the first stop on this road is social media. You might ask now, didn't you just talk about how hard it is to deal with that looseness of the industry, and couldn't it be any better if there were lots of demand? Of course, from a financial angle, this helped out a lot. Way easier to make a living from this right now than in any other time before. And despite it definitely is a big part of it, it's not the full picture. Because if I just wanted to be financially secure and make a lot of money, there are far better jobs out there. But yeah, that was a big part for me. I dove in and I didn't know if I could survive. So obviously I jumped on these projects. But after a while, the more I would be working on these different projects, the less my excitement and my energy had gotten. I felt worn out much faster and I didn't get stimulated creatively. It offered financial stability and ensured me that the business would keep going, which is a fair point, but to what extent? This is something I had to be very mindful of from time to time. It can be very easy to forget why you initially got in. And I think over time, when an overload of random jobs creep in, it's very easy to forget that. You can get stuck in them.
It's our spot for the day. Oh my God, this looks so epic.
Just so inspired by these different landscapes. We only actually drove like 70 kilometers, I think. Stayed close to them, so we could film them.
And down there is Dan and Curly. There's our car, and we go this direction tomorrow.
In this industry right now, it seems like there's such a huge bubble of opportunity out there. There's just so much demand. There's this big bubble, and within the bubble there is a smaller one which contains everything that is appropriate to take on. From a logistical angle, it fits your schedule, its workload is appropriate for your calendar, it's feasible with deadlines. From a financial angle, the budget of the project aligns with what you're charging for. It's very often these two things that need to be checked, and only then the project is clear to work on.
The weather is really shit this morning. It's cold, windy, we're in the middle of nowhere.
We are crossing.
While this inner bubble makes sense on many levels, I wonder if it still helps me to grow as a creative. I like to take this metaphor of exiting this inner bubble and enter the bigger picture, because I knew that there are projects out there that I want to do. Even though they don't make incredibly sense financially or logistically, they help me to move more into the direction where I see myself. And of course, balance is key on that one. You don't want to stay in a small bubble the whole time, because that would fail in the initial motivation and why you got in the first place and eventually burn you out. But you also might not just want to swim in the big waters the whole time, because that can lack instability again, which is really hard to navigate. It's been super important to me from the start to build a community and to find clients in a niche or in a topic that I enjoy. And that's what I did many, many times throughout the last years. The adventures I was able to take on because I entered this bigger bubble have led me to connections I'm immensely grateful for. And you know how it is. One person introduces you to another person, and in the end, this is how more possibilities open up. Including this one.
It's really cold today. As you can see, we're high up in altitude.
And that's exactly what I mean. It's really easy to fall into the trap of staying put, of never exiting this inner bubble.
I'm hiking up this little hill next to the campsite today. Just wanted to see pretty much what is behind this hill.
So as I said in the beginning, I think everyone is going to encounter their own traps, and they're individual. But there has been this pull that has been holding everything together, that guided me through my valleys. And I think this centerpiece is universal, it's valid for everybody. I started making films 12 years ago, when I wanted to capture the excitement we had for doing tricks on a trampoline. I had no clue about any camera settings or softwares. In fact, at the beginning, I disliked all of that. All I wanted was to transport this feeling. And I figured filming was the best way to do that. So the creation of these early attempts of edits came out of the necessity to create this feeling transfer. I knew exactly what I was in for. And as my interest shifted over time, I knew I needed to hold my why very tight. Why am I doing this? How can I deliver the emotion I experience to others? And even though I got lost from time to time, I kept it on high priority to figure it out again. The why is allowed to change, but it must be honest. Otherwise, I think it all falls apart. If it's not for the sincerity and authenticity behind the things we do in life, what else? As life continues, we sometimes get stuck in patterns we've created in the past. And if I experienced that already with my innocent 7 years in, I don't want to know how some older people must feel like. I want to keep finding ways out of my traps. I want to stay dynamic. I want to keep building on myself and see how my why transforms. That's what it means to me to live creatively. That's what makes my life worth living.
This is our last night in the tent.
Without further ado, I won't talk anymore. The Iceland divide. Enjoy. Woo!